Hi there, Richard Dick Coughlan, 616. How are you? I think I'm about to say something bad about Muslims.
Adam Gadon, the so-called American Al-Qaeda, who proclaimed himself the media maven, if you will, for Al-Qaeda, and was helping to produce a lot of these so-called Al-Qaeda videos that were all over the internet that made Al-Qaeda look really bad and made the Muslims look bad.
Because they didn't do a good enough job of that on their own, did they?
Should you fail to comply in full, we will deem it sufficient justification to continue to fight and kill Americans.
Come to find out, Adam Gadon's real name was Adam Perlman. And not only was he, in fact, Jewish, he was the grandson of a member of the board of the Anti-Defamation League.
The video claims that Adam Gadon is Jewish. As far as I can tell, he was never raised religiously Jewish. And in terms of being a culturally Jewish, he's only about one quarter. According to an article that I'll leave a link to in the below, according to that article in the New Yorker, his paternal grandfather was Jewish and his paternal grandmother was Protestant. So even by Jewish law, he doesn't technically classify as Jewish, since because in Jewish law, it passes down from the mother. And I haven't been able to find too many confirming sources of this, but from what I can understand, his mother was indeed Catholic. He also just said that his real name was Adam Perlman. This is not actually true either. Adam's paternal grandparents were called Perlman, but his mother and father changed their last name to Gadon, and this happened before Adam was even born. Every source that I've found, Adam Gadon's legal name has always been Gadon. Gadon and party. And the fact that his mother and father changed their name is not disputed either. And if you look in the link to the article below, you'll see that it actually was confirmed that they changed their names before he was born. Also, the FBI has the Gadon name listed as the real name of Adam Perlman. And it's actually listed as his fifth alias. But of course, the FBI are all in on it, aren't they? Now, it's true that Adam Gadon's grandfather was a member of the ADL. However, this shouldn't really make any difference whatsoever, because so what, his grandfather was a member of the ADL. This video seems to equate cultural Jewishness with religious Jewishness, as if there is absolutely no separation between the two, and once you're a Jew, you're always a Jew. The same way that people do this with Muslims. This video also implies that Adam Gadon's Jewish roots were somehow kept a secret. But he's always been pretty open about it. I'll leave links to a video that was made in 2009. And the fact that he always links to his grandfather rather than his parents suggests to me that it was right to assume that his parents, at least one of them, was not, in fact, Jewish.
And if you've been following the history of the Anti-Defamation League, you will find out they've been very much involved in covertly supporting a lot of these so-called American Nazi movements. In fact, all the way back, just about the time of World War II, there was this scandal where the head of the American Nazi Party, which had a total membership of like six, and yet they were getting all this press, was arrested for embezzling from his sponsors, which turned out to be the ADL, so that kind of blew up in their faces.
Now, this stuff about the American Nazi Party, this is one great big clusterfuck here. Now, the video claims that the American Nazi Party was active during World War II. That's when it was all productive, and was led by a guy called Fritz Kuhn. According to a BBC article I found, link below, the American Nazi Party was actually founded in 1959 by a guy called George Lincoln Rockwell. The Nazi organization that Fritz Kuhn actually led was called German-American Bund. And actually, the American Nazi Party was not founded until years after Kuhn had died. Now, he was a member of a party that did promote Nazi Germany. But there are no sources or links that I can find connecting him with the American Nazi Party. Now, it is possible that the guy narrating this just got confused, but we shouldn't really make that assumption, because the guy should get his fucking facts straight. The video also then claims that the American Nazi Party has a membership of about six. Now, I don't know how many members the American Nazi Party had at any one given time, but according to the US Holocaust Museum, the peak membership of Fritz Kuhn's American Nazi Party was about 25,000. And obviously, even if you're a conspiracy theorist and you're not going to believe this shit, I'm telling you because it's from the US Holocaust Museum and the Jews are all in on it, I can provide you with one image which can be found by simply typing in German-American Bund rally, and you'll find this picture. That is the German-American Bund having a get-together, good old-fashioned party, at Madison Square Garden, which, for those of you who are fans of wrestling, will know holds about 20,000 people. Probably more when you take the ring out. Then the video claims that Fritz Kern embezzled money from the finances of the German-American Bund, which the video claims was the Anti-Defamation League. Now, Kern certainly was indicted for embezzlement, but I couldn't find any evidence to support that it had anything to do with the ADL. And in fact, in the video, you'll see that they show up this clip, this image of a blog. It's sort of like you're sort of not really paying attention. And you'll see it mentions about the ADL being sponsorships, because it's talking about sponsors of the German-American Bund being the ADL. And then it shows up this thing about sponsorship. If you actually look at that image, I'll show it again, all it does is show you that there's a YouTube page that has now been set up by the ADL. So it's got nothing to do with that anyway. It's a completely meaningless image. I'll leave a link to a Times Magazine article where you can find out about the embezzlement case. But I can read this bit from you. The indictment alleged that Fritz Kern stole $8,907 collected at the Bund's February rally in Manhattan. Two, stole $4,424 collected to defend six Long Island Bundsters who were convicted of violating state civil rights law last July. Three, stole $565 of Bund money to move the furniture of a blonde divorcee, Mrs. Florence Camp. Ooh! Ask you now. From Los Angeles to Manhattan. At four, stole $151 to move Miss Camp's furniture to Cleveland. Ha there. And five, stole $500, which supposedly was to pay a Bund lawyer.
Anyway, we have Adam Perlman, and he's been going around saying, I'm Al-Qaeda, see, I got a turban on my head, I'm a terrible Muslim.
I don't think he has actually been doing that. He hasn't been running around going, I'm Al-Qaeda, I'm a terrible Muslim. That would be so crap, wouldn't it?
Gotta hate me, gotta be afraid of me, and of course everybody's laughing at him now because we all know who he is.
Now if you look again at that image, it says there, American Al-Qaeda member acknowledges Jewish ancestry. How can you claim this is a cover-up when you've got links to news articles showing you that he's acknowledging it?
They have brought in the understudy, and there is a new American Al-Qaeda named Yosef Al-Khattab. Ooh, big scary name.
What do you mean big scary name? What do you expect to call him? Barry the Terrorist?
And they've got a picture of him out there where he's holding all these guns and knives and he's dressed up like a wannabe Rambo.
It's epic music, isn't it? It really is good.
And he's scowling at the camera and he supposedly has this website with things in it like pictures of the Statue of Liberty with an axe buried in the back of the head. I mean, very heavy-handed, very over the top.
Well, yeah, they are, mate. It is over the top. They're fundamentalists. They tend to be a bit wacky.
There was also a link to a puppet show mocking Danny Pearl's beheading. Take a look.
Sorry, shouldn't laugh at that.
You know, just looking more like a movie prop than anything else here. So, as it turns out, this is another fake. His real name is Joseph Cohen.
He's a 39-year-old New York City taxi driver, as you mentioned. He called himself Yosef Al-Khattab, but he was born Joseph Cohen here in America. He is a Jew.
Again, they've just shown you a clip of Fox News of him admitting... this. This is not a cover-up or a conspiracy. It's blatantly obvious. But this is feeding into that mentality. He was a convert from Judaism. This is absolutely no secret. There's even an essay, I'll leave a link to it, that you can go watch where he talks about this. And you've got to understand, culturally, in the areas that they're talking about, where you've got Israel, Palestine, the Middle East, being a former Jew converting to Muslim is something that they believe can give you a bit of credence. In the same way that a lot of, in the West, a lot of Christians will claim that they used to be atheists. Not that they're necessarily lying, but it tries to feed into give you a little bit more credibility. And all of this information about him being a former Jew was actually known before Revolution Muslim was even formed. I'll leave links to the stuff below.
With the American Al-Qaeda. And it's all a front. It's a fake. He's up there. He's there to try and create an enemy that doesn't really exist.
That's an interesting point you're making there, because I've done a lot of videos in recent months that were, some of them were response to Pat Condell when he was talking about the Muslim Mafia, and he was talking about the Jihad Prevention Act. This is really where that sentiment does play out, about creating this fake enemy. But here's the problem. This stuff is just as counterproductive as the stuff they are claiming to fight against. If you're fighting an enemy or fighting something that isn't really there, which is what this video and what lots of other videos are trying to do, then you might as well ignore the problem altogether. Because if you're fighting an enemy or fighting a problem that doesn't exist in the first place, you're just creating another problem along with us to fight, and we can't focus on the real problem. This video is bullshit. Revolution Muslim are, as far as I'm concerned, not fake. They are nutters. Oh my god, I just stopped sucking Islamic dick! I would like to also thank the user AntiBoo86. I'll leave a link to his channel below. You can go and subscribe to him, look at his videos. He helped me out a lot with this video. Thank you, AntiBoo. And, but yeah. Richard the Dick Coughlan, 616. Good night. May God be with you.